Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? So, I have brought this train back here, and we'll stick the grain back into our grain bins, and we need to take some corn over to the pigs. When we've done that, we need to get water for all the animals. The forage wagon, though, I'm thinking that we'll keep hold of that for a bit, because we want to get a mower and get some grass in for the cows, so they've got a bit of food. So if we bring that one in here, stop that here. Before I go any further, my question for the week. This map is going to be based mainly on animals. So which animal would you like me to focus on first? Would you like me to focus on... Hang on. There, that's what I wanted. Would you like me to focus on pigs, cows, or sheep first? It's your vote. It's your game. Head to the comment section down below and let me know what you want. Now, I have installed two new mods, and these mods are... it's a ground terrain something. I can't remember what it is now. Ground response, is it maybe? But you just have a look and see. You can see now that the trailer is not jumping up and down like it used to in FS15 with the mod that we were using there. But it is definitely been affected by the terrain that it's on. And from the pictures, when you're ploughing, it gets affected on that as well. Now, another thing that we've got is a new terrain for dirt on wheels, and what it does is it each wheel gets dirty at a different rate depending on what you're driving on. So look at that, the actual wheel is now sort of getting a little bit cleaner because I'm driving across a large area of concrete compared to driving on the mud, and they sort of seem to change according to the surface that you're on, and I really like that. It's a really nice little touch. It doesn't, at the moment, seem to be too drastic for any of it. It does seem to work quite well. So we will test that out a little bit more because, well, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take some corn over to the pigs. Once we've got the corn over to the pigs, we will then be going to go and get a water bowser. And so that means that we're going to be driving on the road a little bit in order to go and get it. And I think this is where we fill up with our grain, right in here. So let's just press R. Yes, we press R, that brings it up. Barley, canola, sunflower, soybean, corn. Start. Right, so we'll take a load of corn there. That's all of the corn, it's just all of it fit into the one trailer. If we just press escape, it will tell us here what we need for our pigs. So, oh no, we don't need to do that. We need to go into animals there. So we got wheat and barley, that's one lot. Corn, that's 50%, that go there. Then we want a protein, which is canola, sunflowers, or soybeans. We've got all three of those, so we can get those. The final 5% is from root crops, potatoes and sugar beet. We don't have any of those. That, to me, I mean, I think I said this in the last episode, that is a bit of a disappointment to me. But, you know, I guess I can live with that. Right. Now, I have something very, very important. I did have someone ask me if I was going to mention everybody that got this right. And now then, quite a few people have answered, and most people have put the same answer. And I'm still not convinced. I showed this to Senleia, and she agrees with the majority of people. So the first person that got the correct answer, according to what Sen thinks the answer is Oliver Does It All. Is what his name is, and he said it's an inspection pit for vehicles, because if you have a look, she said this looks like an old garage, like an old workshop. I'm going to disagree. I would respectfully disagree there. I would say that that could equally be used for stock. This could equally be used for stock. I've had one person say that they think this is an old sheep dip, and that was Billy Norton. Billy Norton said that he thought this was an old sheep dip. Now, I'm going to give you my reasons here. Every pit that I have ever seen, and I've seen a lot, okay? I've seen a lot on lots of different farms, in lots of different garages and workshops, and every single one that I have ever seen has all had one thing in common, and that is they have a lip along the edge and on both sides where you can put sleepers in, and so that you can cover the pit up. This has no such lip, so it's not possible to cover this one up, right? That is my first point. My second point, now, it's entirely possible that it could be in different places, but I have never seen a pit with steps at the end. ever, not once, have I ever seen a pit with steps at the end. It's always been a ladder up the side. Either a ladder or just like a block to stand on to climb out. I've never seen it with steps at the end. I have seen sheep dips without covers, with ramps at both ends. I've only seen photos of the ones with ramps at both ends. The ones that I have used personally have had just a straight drop. This would all be filled up with water, and it's a straight drop on the end, and the sheep would sort of jump into this end, and then they would swim along a sheep dip, and then they would walk out this end. So they'd be completely coated. And the time taken to get through there is how long they need to be submerged in order to effectively protect them against fly strike and such other things. So I would say there's two right answers. The only thing that's going against this potentially being a sheep dip is there's no drain at the bottom. And now I know that not all sheep dips had drains. A lot of them did, in fact, just, you know, leave it full of water, and they would just pour a load more water in to dilute it and then leave it full, or, you know, anything like that. So this could really, that's my reasoning behind this, it could be either. Okay, so I've given two right answers. Everyone, I had loads of people, I think I had over 20, something like 20 to 30 people said, this is an inspection pit. So well done to everybody that said it's an inspection pit, because it could well be an inspection pit. Senlea was convinced that it was, because she said this must be an old workshop. I, on the other hand, I still think this could be a building for working stock, because I have seen these pits before, as sheep dips, used in buildings sort of set up like this, where you can just add in sheep hurdles however you want, and then you've got space for people to work in. The animals, they just come in that end and they go out that end, or vice versa. So yeah, I would say that this really could be either, but only one person who said that it's a sheep dip. Yeah. So that's, I did mention in the comments that I had a bit of explaining to do, because I'm still convinced that this is a sheep dip and not an inspection pit. But I'm willing to accept that I might be wrong, and so I'm giving both right answers. Now anyway, that aside, I'm going to take this over to the pigs so that we can feed them with it, and then we can get started on our next little bit, which is getting the water to the animals. Just pulling up to the pigs, and... Oh, the food was this side, wasn't it? And we also wanted to change it so that it just goes out of the chute on the back. So I'll make sure it does that. Let's go back up. Let's come that way round. Now, we have only got 9 pigs in here, so we're not going to be making vast sums of money out of them. And I'm assuming that you do eventually get pigs that you can sell to the butcher. Or sell to the market, wherever it is that you're going to sell your pigs. Right, that was a very poor effort, but anyway, it's there. That's the bit that counts. It's there. Now, tip side. You, grain door, that's where I want to tip it out of. So then I go I to tip. There we go. And how much is 9 pigs going to take? 9 pigs is going to take a lot of corn. Okay, 6 tons of grain for 6 days. I know it does do it for 6 days, but that is a huge amount of grain. Corn, oh no, not 6 tons, 4 tons. 4 tons of grain. Wheat and barley is 2 tons, and the straw we've got is about just under 2 tons left. So pigs are 9. They're still on 0% productivity. Water. Animals always need water. They won't do anything without water. So we've got the straw. We've got the cleanliness is fine. Now, silage or hay for the animals, for the cattle. I have heard, people have been telling me, that you cannot make silage with cut grass. You can't pick up silage, can't pick up grass with forage wagon and use that to make silage anymore. If this is true, it is very disturbing for me, because I have actually made silage using a forage wagon. It doesn't make it's not as good as a precision chop harvest. But it's good. So that's a little bit upsetting. So we're going to have to figure out something else. Because if you put grass down, you need to get a whole crop cutter in order to do it. I don't think you can use the mech thing that goes on the front of the tractor to do it. It kind of limits your options a bit with grass, to be honest. And that I'm not very happy about. Right, I think we'll worry about silage another time. We need to get water in for the animals first. That's the important thing. So let's just tip this here. And I must say, with the tip anywhere feature, this is actually going to prove quite useful, because what we could do is put a couple piles. We could put a pile of corn, a pile of, you know, all the different foods that are needed by the pigs. We could put piles of those up at the pig yard, and they'll be happy. That'll be everything that they need. We don't need to worry about it. For now, we've got rental costs on all of these things. And I have since found out that if you don't take something back, I think actually someone said in one of the comments, but I'm sorry, I don't remember who it was that said it. If you have rental machines, you keep them on rental until you send them back. That combine is going to be expensive on our rental, on our ownership list. It costs us a lot. We found that out in Goldcrest Valley. So it might actually be worth selling that combine. I want to keep the two tractors. I want to keep them working. This tractor over here, actually, now that we got the small, we could use the smaller tractor on pulling the water, and we could put the bigger tractor on a cultivator and cultivate the field. We're not going to worry about ploughing it just now. I know that it does need ploughing, but I think we'll leave the ploughing for now, and we'll just cultivate it. And we want silage for the cows. What else are we going to... We want hay... Well, hay or silage for the cows. We also want some other food as well, don't we? Right, let's just take a look. What do we want for cows? Cows need... Well, they need the water, and they've got the straw. They need just grass. Okay, so we can do grass with the forage wagon. Then they need silage and hay. Silage, we need... Well, we could do grass, and we could make hay. We don't have to give them silage to start with. And then power food. I'm assuming that's mixed rations. And the mixed rations is still silage, hay, and straw. Now, I think that's a little unfortunate, and I have said this before, and I'm going to say it again. It disappoints me that mixed rations for cows don't require any grains to go in them. I think it would have been much better if they had put it so that you had to put a few grains into them as well. So I'm a little bit disappointed about that. Oh, no, stop. I don't want to do that yet, do I? I want to fertilize this field first. I want to spread fertilizer on the field, and after I've done that, then I want to cultivate it so that I get a couple of growth stages in. So we'll do that, and then we can go and get the... Because we've got fertilizer in this one here. It's got 508 in the fertilizer. So I can set this one going on the fertilizer. Then I can get the cultivator going. And then once we've done that, then we can go and get the water. So, I mean, it shouldn't take too long to do the fertilizing with this one. If I just put H, so that one gets going. Right, he can go off. He's going to do that. Look at him bouncing away with this new mod. That's brilliant. And that's so much more accurate than that. The other one was good in that, you know, the wheels went into the ground and that, but the bouncing that you had, I really didn't like that. I did not like the way that it bounced all the time. Whereas this one, it doesn't bounce. It moves up and down. It shows that you do have some rough ground there. What does it do when we go over it with in the cultivated ground? Look at that. And also, is something else that it said about this this mod? It said that if you use it in the rain, you will actually have your wheels slipping a bit. And I'm guessing that could be used in other maps and stuff. Right, let's just go for hired help on this. He can go up across. Right, now he's cultivating in the fertilizer. Excellent. So that one's going to go on. He's going to drive through the bushes. We'll let that one finish. Yeah, right through the bushes. That's the problem with the hired help. It's not always the smartest. But anyway, that one can carry on. That will spread that field. And then when it's spread the field, we can unhitch the fertilizer spreader. We can go and get the water bowser. This one can go and do the cultivating. When he's finished cultivating, we'll do another layer with fertilizer. So that will be a second spread of fertilizer. And then we can see about spreading some, sowing something. And I'm actually thinking we should plant grass on this one. Because grass actually uses the, you can fertilize grass as well. It does benefit from it now. But I'm not sure if this grass benefits from it, or if it's just grass that's sown in a field that benefits from it. Now, that's something that I haven't found out yet. Because if you plant grass here, this will benefit from fertilizer, apparently. If you plant grass here, benefits from fertilizer, but you keep the dirt texture underneath. If you want the grass texture, you've actually got to go over it with the roller. So we'll get to that. That is probably something that we'll do in the future. So I need to decide if I want grass so that I can give grass straight to the cattle and maybe do a bit of hay as well. Or do I want to just... I could plant corn in this one. Then we could make a bit of silage. That should be enough so that we can sheet down a little clamp of silage there, just from this small field. I'll have a think about that. While these two tractors finish up this field, I'll have a think about it. I'm just riding in the tractor for the last line up through. I am loving this ground mod that we've got going. It is quite bouncy at times, but I am loving this. This is brilliant. I am really, really pleased with this. You notice it a bit when it's driving around, but you really notice it when it's doing that. Now then, I also really like the intelligent sort of thought process that does go into the hired help turning round at times. I don't want it to do it anymore. There's a little tiny strip down the edge of the field. I'm not too worried about that. That can just stay there. So that tractor over there, he's going to carry on and do the cultivating. We will come through here and we will drop off the fertilizer spreader right here. We need to go and hire. Now, of course, the main thing that I need to worry about is, do I want to keep that Joskin's animal trailer on hire? Unhitch that one. Let's see, how much is that costing us? Need to go to our garage, and then you go sideways to your leased items. Now, this one... What's it saying? Ah, so you can just return it. Right, it's not telling us how much it is. It's a bit of a shame. Shop. Back. Right, so we have to actually go to the section to be able to get it, and well, it was in animals, wasn't it? Joskin. Right, that one is 2,640. Oh, hang on. Per day, base cost. Per operating hour, 1,200 euros. Initial cost, 2,400, but then per day, 240 euros. Ah. Does that mean it's not going to cost us 2,600 every day? Does it mean that the actual lease cost is a lot lower? So when I returned, let's go to this one, 1,000 per day, 95. Now what is that? That's per operating hour. So I'm guessing that's when you're actually using it. The base cost of the rental is that. You pay for the first hour in advance, and then you have the daily rate as well. So lease, yes. What we need to find out is at midnight how much it changes, I think. Because in Goldcrest, I sent back my Pottinger because I thought, well, that's costing us 3,600 per day. And that's why I sent it back, because I sort of got in a bit of a panic. I thought, oh, you know, we're not going to be able to do this. Just hang on a sec. Just look at the wheels on the tractor. Now that we've got onto the road, they're nearly clean. And that's generally what happens on the road. You know, your tyres do come up with a bit of a shine. Brilliant. I'm loving these mods. These are produced by Giants, by the way. The ground terrain thing and the wheels thing and the crop destruction one that we use as well. This all Giant software have released them as mods, which I think is excellent. I'm really pleased with what they're doing with this game. It's absolutely fabulous. We'll have to investigate this a little more closely. Is it that we... I was mistaken in Goldcrest, and that Pottinger wasn't going to cost me $3,500 a day. Same as these here. We got this one here. Isn't going to cost me 1,000 euros per day to keep. It's going to be a lot less than that per day to keep. It's just the initial cost when you first go to your lease agreement. That's what's going to be a bit more pricey. I'm quite pleased with that, actually. It does make a bit of a difference. We'll have to see. Right, let's take this back to the farm, and then we can fill it up with water and get some water to the pigs and to the cows so that they can start making us a bit of money. Because one thing that I really like about this, the new version, is if you've got to get water to your animals, but if you don't get water to your animals, it doesn't matter what else you've got in for them. If they don't have water, they produce nothing. It's a little detail. It's only a small detail, but it is an absolutely brilliant one as far as I'm concerned. Now I have to remember where the water pump is. And do you know, I haven't got a clue. Probably here somewhere. Let's try driving around here. That field there, I'd like to buy that one soon. That one's quite a big, it's a big long field. I'm guessing that the task involved with that field will be combining it. So we might do that, actually, so that we can test one of the bigger combines. Because I'm fairly certain that that would be what that job would be. Right, where's the water? I'm sure the water was here somewhere. Where is it? Most likely it's right next to the cow pasture, so that you can, and you've actually got to transport it from next to the cows to the cows so that they've got water. Well, so far, no luck. Well, I'm quite impressed with this. If you reverse the machine right into the water, you can actually refill from the water. So I don't know if there's a water trough somewhere, but we can back it into the water. And also, if you do that though, all the water graphics disappear. So now we just have this great big empty sand pit. And then if you come up, it's just... There we go. Right, brilliant. So anyway, we do have water. I have found the water. Now I've got to get it back to my cow. So I'm assuming that we can actually fill from anywhere that there is water. I didn't actually look at the euro payment thing up in the corner. Did I get charged for extracting the water from the river there? And there, I might well be. But for those of you who are saying that that might not be realistic, just keep in mind, I don't know what it's like in other countries, but here in the UK, if you have animals and you want to take water from for them out of the river, you have certain rights for your animals to go and drink directly from a river if a river goes through your land. However, I think I've just gone past. I think my water trough is actually the other end of the field. So let's just go around. However, what you do need to do, if you want to take water from the river to either just to pump it out of the river to give your animals a drink, into sheds, even into the field, anything like that, you need what's called, or if you want to build like a pool so the water goes into a pool, you need either an extraction license or an abstraction license. And there's actually two different things. If you build a pool, the abstraction license is it's all a bit complicated, but it's to do with which is it? Right, that puts water in there. Yeah, it's to do with if you've got a pool that the river runs through, then there's more evaporation off of it, and so you have to pay for being allowed to do that. And you also have to pay, if you want to take water out of a river, you have to pay the Environment Agency for an extraction license. Well, I don't know how much the extraction license costs, but you do need to pay for an extraction license in order to be able to take water out of a river to give to your animals. Which is basically what we're doing here. So if you're taking water out of the rivers around here, we're basically just paying for an extraction license. But it's being done on a per litre basis rather than for a general yearly basis. So that's how I'm looking at it. So I don't think that it's unrealistic that we are paying for the water that we take out of the river. I just got an achievement. Breakneck bankruptcy. I'm not sure if that's just because we've gone into minus money, or if it's because we did it in the first day, because we're still on the first day. I really don't know, to be honest. How is it that we've gotten that one already? I don't know where you look to see how you you get your achievements. Anyway, we are here at the pigs. It is 7 o'clock in the evening, so we want to put this in for them. What we'll do with our cultivator, he will continue cultivating through the night before tomorrow's episode, and then unload. Is that all? Pigs don't need very much water at all, do they? No, I don't want that one. I want that one. And animals, right. They're still on zero productivity. Water, straw, corn, wheat, barley. So we need to get grass in for the cows now. And the... That's 30% for the power food. Base food is silage or hay for them. And for these, grains is 25%. So disappointed that you don't need the potatoes and sugar beet for more than just 5% of the pigs. I really wanted it to be more than that. Anyway, we could do with bringing up some canola or something for the pigs. We'll worry about that another time. And I think... No, I'll take the water bowser back with me. I'll take that back now. Yeah, we'll... I was thinking that we would put grass in that field so that we can do some grass for the cows, make a bit of hay or something. But we got all this grass up here. There's a great big open area here that we don't need to pay for. And there's another one right there in front of us. So we got these two areas here that we can use for grass. We could do one of them just for grass for the cows, and we could do the other one for hay, which means that we could... We can plant something in that field that we're cultivating right now. I'm thinking, actually, we'll plant corn in there, so then we can do some maize silage. The only way that we're going to be able to afford to do maize silage at the moment is if we use the small tractor-mounted one. I have heard quite a few people on the forums saying that they're not happy about something in particular, and that is, in the US, and to a lesser extent these days here in the UK, you see an awful lot of tractor-pulled foragers, forage harvesters. Precision chop forage harvesters, and you either have... So it goes on the back of the tractor, and then someone's either going alongside it, or you put the trailer directly on behind that. And that is what farmers use their silage. It's used a lot in the US. It's also used quite a bit here in the UK. If a farmer does their own silage, they generally have one of their own foragers, which is the small tractor-towed one. If a farmer is having a lot of silage done, the forage... I'm wording this badly. A small farmer that does his own silage will use one of those. A bigger farmer, or a farmer that doesn't do his own silage, it will be done with a self-propelled one, because all of the big contracting groups... They all use the self-propelled foragers. So if you're using, if they're using a self-propelled forager, right? How did I want to do this? I wanted to put more fertilizer on this, didn't I? So I just want to back up and get fertilizer. I'm just about out of time as well. So you see the big self-propelled foragers that we've got here, and I have had a look through. This is the ones that I'm talking about. So we got these self-propelled ones. We got three of them, and then you got this one, which is goes on the front of the tractor. We just take a look at this one. It doesn't say a lot about it, the MEX 5. It says that it can do silage. I'm assuming that it can only do maize silage. It's a 2.2 meter width. It's not very big. We did use it for a bit in Melbury Estate, didn't we? And I don't think we got on very well with it. I'm assuming that it's improved a little bit since then. But that's the one that we've got available. And then you've got the great big self-propelled forage harvesters. And... What people want to see is like the halfway between the tractor pulled forager that does the same thing as these, but not this little tiny one. And it would be able to pick up grass and do the whole crop. It'll do all of it. It's just pulled by a tractor. So it's kind of halfway between, halfway between the two for cost. But anyway, that is neither here nor there at the moment. I'm assuming that somewhere, because it's... being talked about an awful lot, I'm assuming that someone... It would help if I went to the right side of this one, I suppose. I'm assuming that someone is actually going to make that mod so that we will see it in the future. The mods are coming thick and fast from giants themselves and from plenty of other people, so there's lots of exciting things to see very soon in the future. My weekly question is, which animal would you like me to concentrate on first? I will be trying to get all of the animals... but, you know, plenty of them. I know we've only got just a couple of all of them so far. I'll be trying to get more of all of them. So do you want me to really go all out on cows first, pigs first, or sheep first? It's your vote. It's your game. Head to the comment section down below and let me know your preferences. That is really all I've got time for today. So if you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. I'm going to start spreading fertilizer on this one. I'll use the hired help to do it because he's better than I am. Anyway, until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye and see you later.